Up until 1945, Vietnam had been under French rule. But on August 14, 1945, the Vietnamese, under the leadership of Ho Chi Minh, rebelled against the French. To many people's surprise, the Vietnamese defeated this great Western power and won their independence. Now Vietnam had to decide what form of government it would have. With the Soviet Union, China, and later North Korea already communist, the U.S. could not afford to lose another Asian nation to communism. So much like Korea, Vietnam was split into two nations, Communist North Vietnam and Democratic South Vietnam. United States involvement in Vietnam started on November 1, 1955, when President Dwight D. Eisenhower sent the Military Assistance Advisory Group to help train and advise the South Vietnamese Army. The U.S. slowly escalated their aid to the South while still not going to war. Then, on August 2, 1964, the USS Maddox, while on patrol, was fired upon by three North Vietnamese torpedo boats. This act officially started the Vietnam War. President Lyndon B. Johnson issued this speech to the
United States. Viewed hostile actions against United States ships on the high seas in the Gulf of Tonkin have today required me to order the military forces of the United States to take action in reply.
The South Vietnam were not only fighting the North Vietnamese, but also the Viet Cong. The Viet Cong were a group of South Vietnamese militants who preferred the Northern communist way of life. The U.S. often did not realize they were actually helping the Viet Cong since they had no formal uniforms and lived in the South. To try to defeat the North and Viet Cong, the U.S. went on mass bombing raids. These killed countless civilians and destroyed hundreds of towns and villages. The war continued to escalate, and in 1969, the draft lottery was put into place. Thousands of young men got letters like this one, telling them they had to go to war and fight for their country. Chris Hankel was one of those men.
Were you drafted?
Yes, I was drafted out of college.
What year?
1969.
And what year did you arrive in Vietnam?
I arrived in Vietnam 2 days before Christmas, 1969.
How old were you?
I was 19.
How long were you in Vietnam?
A year.
Where were you for?
I was deployed. I was in the infantry, so I flew in to Cameron Bay for some indoctrination into country, as they call it. And I was assigned to the Big Red 1 unit infantry, which was working out of Dao Tien Yang in Phu Chi at the time.
What was the atmosphere like in Vietnam when you got there?
The atmosphere was a war atmosphere. I remember flying in at nighttime and the pilot telling us he had to turn all the inside lights on the plane off and we could only look out and see fires down in the jungle.
Did you kill anyone in combat?
Yes, I did kill him.
Did that change your opinion of the war?
No, it did not change my opinion of the war.
Did you agree with the U.S. on doing that?
As a young man, idealistic young man, yes, I did agree with the U.S. As a soldier, and I still agree with them today. We did the right thing.
Were many of your unit, were many members of your unit killed during
that? I had a few friends die.
In January of 1973, the Paris Peace Accords were signed by both sides in an attempt to stop fighting in Vietnam. Even with a treaty signed, the war continued. On August 15, 1973, after suffering heavy losses, the U.S. pulled out of the war in Vietnam with the passing of the Case-Church Amendment. This law banned all future U.S. military involvement in Vietnam. On April 30, 1975, North Vietnamese troops captured Saigon, the South Vietnamese capital. Earlier that morning, all American officials and thousands of South Vietnamese had left the city in a mass helicopter evacuation. After 19 years, 5 months, 4 weeks, and a day, the war in Vietnam was over, and the Communist North had won. By the time the war ended, about 3,886,026 people had died, 2,500,000 of which were civilians, and about 2 million people were injured.
How were you treated when you returned?
Coming back from Vietnam, when I was coming through Oakland, California, I was waiting for a flight to come home to New Orleans, and I was at the bar getting a drink with a couple of buddies, and a couple of hippies came up and one spit on me because I was in uniform and called me a baby killer. Other than that, I was treated pretty good.
Did you hear of anyone else who was treated poorly?
At reunions, we talk about things like that. Some friends felt they were treated very poorly. Coming back, there were no specific incidents like the one I mentioned. They just felt they weren't accepted back by society.
And did these things change your opinion of America?
No. No, not in any way.
Why do you think kids today need to learn about the Vietnam War?
I think the Vietnam War was an important part of history. One, for me serving there. Two, because many of the Vietnamese who we freed have come to this country and they've become doctors, lawyers, have gotten great jobs, make great neighbors. I think it gives us a better understanding of their culture while they're here in the United States as United States citizens.